Welcome to our fall crafting adventure. With autumn's crisp air and vibrant colors to inspire us, we're diving into some fun and festive projects that capture the essence of the season. Whether you're looking to decorate your home or make a heartfelt gift, we've got the perfect fall craft for you. Hi, my name is Katie from Lady Red Crafting. Let's gather our supplies and get creative together. We're going to start this inspiration today using four Dollar Tree 5x7 canvases. And for our first step is just removing the canvas from the frame. And to do this, I'm just using some pliers and a screwdriver, and I'm just going to remove the staples from the back. Now, with the magic of video, we'll go ahead and speed this up, and you can see that we've taken off our canvas and we have four blank frames ready to go. Next, I'm going to take my Waverly Antique Wax and stain all of these frames. And if you haven't done this before, I just use a baby wipe and wipe them down and then let them dry. Next, we're going to take some wood glue and a little bit of hot glue, and we're going to go ahead and make what looks like a window panel. So we're just going to attach these together, and I'm using my pink clips that I got from the Dollar Tree. You could use some clamps or simply just hold them together long enough for the hot glue to set and then set this down on a flat surface to dry. Next, we repeat the same steps on the other two frames and let them dry as well. Once those are completely dry, we're going to go ahead and attach the two pieces together using the same method with the wood glue and the hot glue. Now, here's what your frame will look like when that is completely dry. Now, let's go ahead and do all of our embellishments to this fun window. I'm going to start out with this wood truck that I got at the Dollar Tree, and I'm going to tape it down to a paintable surface. By taping this down, it's not going to move on you when you're trying to paint. It also is great for you to be able to kind of lift that piece of cardboard up so that you can get those outside edges really easily without getting your fingers all messy. So it's one of my tricks that I like to do. So we're starting out with Apple Barrel Tuscan Teal. And next, I'm going to use my Terracotta Black for the wheels. And I used the terracotta black because it had a little bit of a texture to it, and I thought that kind of fit in with what the truck wheels would be like. For the wood feature on our truck, I'm just going to use Waverly chalk paint in the color truffle. And for the bumpers on our truck, I'm going to use Waverly chalk paint in the color elephant. I'm also going to use this elephant color to just give some highlights to the truck, to kind of give it some dirt and rust look on our truck. And for our final color on this truck, I'm using Waverly chalk paint in the color sandstone, and we're just going to do a little bit of highlights on that wood part of the truck. Once our truck has dried, I am grabbing out the stencil that I got last year on Amazon, and it is still available, so I'll put a link for it in my description box below. And we're just going to use the happy harvest portion of the stencil, so we're not going to use the pumpkin or the leaf. So I'm just going to center that underneath the window of the truck, and using my chalk paste by Redesign, and it's this vintage lace. It's like a light off-white white, and we're just going to go ahead and squeegee that over the top of our stencil, and then we'll remove this stencil. Now, this fall set of stencils that I got, I came with six different stencils, and I have used them on multiple projects for the last 2 years. So I think it was a really good investment for $6.99, little over a dollar a stencil, but I keep reusing these over and over again. They wash up great. So back to our cute little truck. I think this stencil turned out great on this truck. I'm going to set this aside to dry. At Dollar Tree this year, this is a new item that I've found, and it's this fun garland that has pumpkins on the garland. And so I am going to actually take these pumpkins off the garland, and they're just hot glued together. And when you take them off, you'll have six little pumpkins. And I really like these metal pumpkins, and we're going to put three of them in the back of our truck. Next, we'll save those beads. I'll leave them on the strand so they're easier to store. Now let's go grab our little truck and three of these pumpkins. To attach these pumpkins, what I'm going to do is I'm going to glue them onto the back side of this truck. And I'm just using some hot glue to do this, but I am going to have the pumpkin kind of stick up a little bit higher than the bottom there, just so they kind of poke out of the truck. And for the third pumpkin, I'm just going to stick that kind of on the top, like a little pyramid coming out of the truck. Be really careful. I was putting the hot glue directly on the back side and then putting down my pumpkins, but you can notice that I'm not holding on to it for very long because that metal does get hot with the hot glue. So while that is drying, I am going to make up all the rest of the embellishments that we're going to use for our window frame, and then I'm going to show you how to put this all together. So I'm starting out with a pick that I got from the Dollar Tree, and this is just one pick, and I'm taking it apart. Next, we'll go ahead and gather up three of the pieces and make a mini bouquet and take some floral tape to attach it. Now that those bouquets are finished, we'll set those aside and we'll start working on our farmhouse bow. For our first step on this bow is we're taking some wired ribbon and I'm just going to make the shape of a bow. Once I've done that, I'm going to add an additional loop on either side until I have three loops on either side of my bow. Next, I'll just go ahead and cut the ribbon from the spool. And we're just going to continue to hold that ribbon in the center and we're squishing that together and then you add a little pipe cleaner and twist that around as tight as you can and this keeps the shape of the bow all nice and pretty. Now once you have that pipe cleaner attached, I'm going to take a small piece of the same ribbon and I'm going to fold it into thirds. And what we'll do is we're going to wrap that around the piece of pipe cleaner to cover that up and finish our bow. And to attach, I'll use some hot glue on the back side of the bow. Now all you have to do is fluff out your bow and decide how you want your tails to look on the edges of your bow. Now the fun part, let's put all of these things together. So I'm going to take this adorable truck and we're going to take hot glue and a little bit of wood glue and we're going to add that to the center bar of this window. So I'm starting out with the wood glue because that takes a lot longer to dry. And then quickly I'll use my hot glue and add a stripe of that onto our little row and then place down that truck. And the hot glue just helps that truck adhere to the wood quicker, and then that wood glue will take a little bit longer to dry. And once your truck is in place, we'll go ahead and grab those little bouquets that we made. And we're going to take those bouquets and we're going to line that on the bottom row of this window. And I'm using two zip ties to go ahead and attach those bouquets. And I wanted the window to be able to sit flush against a wall when I hung it. So I used the zip ties and I closed them at the front of the bouquets. And to cover up those zip ties, I took a piece of raffia and I just tied it in a simple knot. And we're going to hot glue that to the front. And I thought that we might need a little bit more at the bottom of this window. So what I did is I had another pick that I had gotten from the Dollar Tree. And this one had a mini pumpkin on it as well. And we're just going to attach that right to the center just to kind of make it more of our centerpiece on the bottom. And for the top of our window, we are going to add our bow that we made. And I'm just using hot glue to attach the bow. Now I flip this over and I'm going to add a quick little hanger. I'm using some jute and I made a little loop. And using hot glue, I'm just going to attach that to our frame. Now let's go ahead and flip this frame over and check out our adorable truck. And I just love how this piece turns out. This just screams fall to me. The truck, the pumpkins, the wood, the farmhouse feel it has. This may be one of my favorite fall decor pieces. I would love to know what you think. Please feel free to leave a comment below and let me know what your favorite is today. For this craft, we're going to transform this wood box from the Dollar Tree, a staple in the Crafter Square section, into a adorable wheelbarrow. We're going to start out by painting our little box with some Waverly chalk paint in the color Plaster. And once our paint has completely dried, I'm taking some Waverly chalk paint in the color Ink, and I'm going to just dry brush around the outside of this box. And while we have our ink paint out, I'm going to go ahead and paint two of my tumbling tower blocks that I got from the Dollar Tree. And then I painted two square dowels that I found on Amazon. And if you can't find these dowels, chopsticks or round dowels will work just the same. Let's set these aside to dry and go back to our wood box. I have this adorable stencil that I did get on Amazon, and I'll put a link for it in my description box below. These work great for ornaments and all sorts of different things. We're going to place this on the side of our little box, and using some redesigned chalk paste in the color Iron Gate, we're going to just go ahead and squeegee that over the top of our stencil. And then we'll remove the stencil, and I washed it and did the same thing on the other side. Next, let's work on our wheel for our wheelbarrow. I am using an ornament piece. This is a wood slice, and this one had a eye hook at the top. So I just removed that from my ornament, and I'll save that eye hook for another craft. Now, using our Waverly chalk paint in the color Ink, we'll go ahead and paint both sides of this wood slice. Paint has dried. I grab my Waverly chalk paint in the color Plaster, and I'm just going to go ahead and dry brush around the outside edge of our wood slice. And while we have our plaster colored paint out, I want to paint two little half beads, and I'm taking a piece of painter's tape and I just lay that out onto my piece of cardboard, and I'm just going to place those wood beads on top so that they don't move around, making it a lot easier to paint and keeping my hands mess free. Now, once all of our pieces have completely dried, I'm going to put together our little wheelbarrow, and I'm using wood glue and hot glue for this. And we're starting out by adding our little tumbling blocks to the back side of this wood box. Now let's go ahead and make our wheel for our wheelbarrow. I am using my two wood dowels and some wood glue and a little bit of hot glue. And I'm starting out by just doing the first wood dowel on the wheel. I'm trying to align it up right where I would like it. I'm adding that hot glue to the skewer, and we're just going to go ahead and place that at a slight angle. And this is probably the hardest part of the whole entire craft, is getting that right angle on our wheel. And once you get that perfect, you go ahead and do the next side the exact same way. I didn't have to hold this while it was drying. I did use my pink clip from the Dollar Tree, and I just attached that at the end of the wheel there. And once that has completely dried, I take my hot glue and I'm going to just hot glue my half beads to the end of that dowel. And then we repeat that same step for the other bead, and our little wheel base is ready to attach to our wheelbarrow. And to attach our wheel base, I'm just flipping our box over, and we'll use some hot glue to attach our base to our box. And what I love about this wheelbarrow is you can decorate it any way you'd like for whatever season. So for this season, for the fall, I'm going to add a little bit of stuffing into the box, and I'm using some black and white checkered ribbon to go around the edge of the box just to give it a little bit more dimension. And for my final add, I'm going to take these velvet pumpkins that I got from the Dollar Tree, and I'm just going to stick them inside the wheelbarrow. And I just love how this wheelbarrow turned out. It is amazing. And I cannot wait to display this for multiple seasons. Let me know in the comments below what you would display in your little wheelbarrow. And if you're enjoying this content, Please don't forget to hit that subscribe button below. It really helps my channel grow. Thank you. Let's transform this wood house into a beautiful decor piece for your tiered tray or as a shelf sitter. For our first step, we're going to take a piece of painter's tape and tape this down to a paintable surface. Now that that is secure, I'm grabbing my Waverly chalk paint in the color truffle and I'm going to give a nice coat over the top of this wood piece. I also did paint the sides of this wood piece because if you're looking at it from a tiered tray, you still may see those. Now I'm grabbing my Waverly chalk paint in the color plaster and this amazing stencil that I found on Amazon this year, and I'll put a link for it in my description box below so you can check it out. Now we're just gonna lay this over the top of our little house. Next, I grabbed a sponge brush that I got from the Dollar Tree, and I'm just going to tap that down on a little piece of scrap paper there before I go ahead and I start painting my stencil. So while we have a moment, I want to tell you all about this amazing playlist I'm a part of, Recreations Inspiration. And my co-host is Loli from Loli D Creations. Our guest host this month is Marla from The Chic Show. And for this month's video, all of my creations were inspired by Rebecca Virginia DIYs. Rebecca is an amazing creator, and if you haven't checked out her YouTube channel, please check her out and see what she is up to. I have linked her inspiration video in my description box below, as well as the playlist and these lovely hosts. Please check them out and give them some love. I really think you will enjoy all of what they're creating today. Now that we have our paint applied to our stencil, we're going to go ahead and just remove that really carefully. And this turns out amazing. You could leave it just like this, but I'm going to embellish it. We're using these fun cutouts from the Dollar Tree, and I'm just using one of the maple leaves. I'm taping this on to a paintable surface, and then using my Waverly chalk paint in the color plaster will give a nice coat over the top of this leaf. Sometimes hot glue is not the right method for attaching things, and I felt that way for this project. So I'm using my Elaine's Tacky Glue and a paintbrush. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to paint a stripe of glue along the center of this little wood piece. And once we have enough glue in the center, I'm going to place a little piece of burlap over the top of that glue. And I did fray the edges on this ahead of time just to give it a little bit more texture. Now for my next step, I'm going to go ahead and do the exact same thing with the glue, and I'm going to do a stripe of glue over the top of the burlap. But this time, I am going to add a ribbon to that piece of glue. Now, once those pieces have dried, I'm going to do the exact same thing for the last piece. But for this one, we're going to do it a little bit different. I flip over our leaf, and I'm using the same Aileen's Tacky Glue, and I'm going to brush the back side of the leaf to get glue on all sides. And now we'll just place that right in the center of our piece. And that's all there is to it. This perfectly simple little shelf sitter is ready to display on your tiered tray or on a shelf. And there you have it, three beautiful fall crafts to start the autumn season. I hope you enjoyed these crafts as much as I did. And if you're looking for some more fun fall creative craft ideas, be sure to check out our next video. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you never miss an update. Thank you so much for watching, and until next time, craft more, stress less.